All right, and looking at the chain ganglia here, we can see it's made up of all of these ganglions, right? Or ganglia or ganglion singular. There's actually 23 of them. You can only see three here, but it's a long chain of 23 ganglia, and three are in the cervical, 11 are in the thoracic, and so on and so on. I'm not going to hold you to these numbers. Just realize that it's just a lot longer than you see here and occurs on either side, both sides, I should say, of the spine. Now, a preganglionic fiber. By the way, when we say preganglionic fiber, we mean neuron or axon, right? Preganglionic axon, preganglionic neuron or fiber. When it enters the sympathetic chain or sympathetic trunk chain ganglia, three things can happen. So I know you can read those three things. I'm going to go to the pictures to go through these three possibilities. We already know, we already mentioned them, but let's go through them individually using some more pictures. All right, so starting in our lateral horn, there's a lateral horn right there, lateral gray horn. That's where our sympathetic nervous system begins, right? It's peripheral nervous system, it's motor. So remember, it's always, well, except for one exception, a two-neuron chain. So here's our preganglionic neuron cell body. There's the axon. It's leaving that lateral horn. There's the ventral root, becomes the spinal nerve, and then this dark green preganglionic neuron will go through the white rami communicantes or white ramus, and now we're inside the sympathetic chain ganglia. So what can happen? Well, number one of our possibilities is it synapses right here. So you can see the synapse. We go from dark green to light green, and now after the synapse, we have our postganglionic neuron in light green that leaves the sympathetic chain through the gray ramus and then out to the effectors. And since this is the autonomic nervous system, the effectors can be smooth muscle, skeletal muscle, or glands, like we see here. So there's our preganglionic and postganglionic. So possibility one, yes, it does synapse in the sympathetic chain at that same level that it entered. All right, another possibility is it synapses in the chain again, but not at the level it enters. It can take an elevator up, elevator down, right? Could go up more than one level. It can go down one level or more than one level. Remember, this is the cranial, sorry, this is the thoracolumbar division, but the chain will go past that. It'll go up into the cervicals, down into the lower lumbars, right? So this sympathetic chain is a way for fibers to get beyond thoracolumbar into other areas of the body. So just kind of let's follow our second possibility. There's our lateral gray horn. Here's our preganglionic neuron. It's leaving the spinal cord, ventral root, spinal nerve. It takes the white ramus into the sympathetic chain. It does not synapse at the level it enters. In this case, it happens to go up a level, then synapses. So there's our postganglionic neuron leaving the sympathetic chain through the gray ramus and then to the effector. But it's still a two-neuron chain. So in possibility one, it synapsed in the sympathetic chain at the level it entered. Possibility two enters the chain, goes to a different level, then synapses before the postganglionic neuron leaves.